To create a cover page with a full page background image in Word, we first of all activate the formatting symbols in the paragraph section, and then we go to the Layout tab, click on Breaks, and insert a standard page break. This will make sure that we can afterwards insert content on page 2 and onwards without destroying the formatting on the cover page. Then we can already drag the desired image from the Windows Explorer into the Word document. Afterwards, we select the image and a small button will appear in the top right corner. We click on this button and choose the text wrapping option behind text. And by the way, if you don't see this button, you will also find the text wrapping options in the Format tab. To now resize the image, we have to know the dimensions of our paper size. To find that out, we go to the Layout tab, click on Size, and there we can see that the current document is an A4 standard sized document with a height of 29.7 cm. With the image still selected, we switch back to the Format tab and enter the 29.7 cm for the image height so that it is large enough to cover the full page. Afterwards, we move the image to focus on the part of the image that we like, and to be sure that it is vertically centered, we click on Align, make sure that Align to Page is selected, click again on Align, and select Align Middle. This will perfectly center our image relative to the page. After inserting the image, we can now do all sorts of additional stuff. First, let's go to File, Info, and set a title for our document. Then we go back and switch to the Insert tab, where we click on Text Box and select Simple Text Box to insert it. Now we again go to the Insert tab, click on Quick Parts, Document Property, and select Title. This will implement a linked field to the title in our document info settings. Afterwards, we click on the border of the text box, go to the Format tab, click on Shape Outline, and select No Outline. And then we also click on Shape Fill, and select a custom fill color. To vertically center the content within the text box, we switch to the Layout tab, and make sure that the before and after values are set to 0. If you would like a larger spacing around the text, you can also type a number aside from 0, just make sure that the before and after values are the same so that everything is symmetrical. Then we switch to the Home tab, and there we click on the Line Spacing button and select 1.0. This will again help to keep a symmetrical look. Now let's choose a nice font for the title and also increase its size. The size increase might lead to multiple line breaks, so we simply make the text box wider. Then we will additionally make the title all caps. For that, we click on the little arrow in the bottom right corner of the font section, and in the new window we check the box which says all caps, and we confirm everything with a click on OK. Now we might have to resize the text box again, and we can position it where we want. In case we have a subtitle for our document or need a text box for an additional line, let's copy the existing text box by pressing the keyboard shortcut Ctrl and C, and then we immediately paste it with the keyboard shortcut Ctrl and V. To remove the title field from this box, we click on the three little dots where it says title, and we hit the backspace key. Now we can insert a subtitle, and to create a better contrast, we click on the border of the text box and again switch to the Format tab, where we set the background color to white. To further increase the contrast, we switch to the Home tab, select a different font, and make the font size a bit smaller. If our subtitle is a lot shorter than our title, we can additionally increase the spacing between the letters. For that, we click on the little arrow in the bottom right corner of the font section, and in the new window, we switch to the Advanced tab. There, we open the spacing dropdown, set it to expanded, and we can change the expansion by a desired amount. Afterwards, we resize the text box and move it slightly below the title to create this overlapping effect. Additionally, we can of course also insert any type of picture onto the page. We just have to make sure that the text wrapping is set to in front of text so that we can freely move the image on the page. And one last thing, if we ever want to change the object layers, we can click on Select and open the Selection pane. In this pane, we can for example drag the title text box below the subtitle text box, and with that, the method of overlapping will change. Note, however, that we are not able to move the background picture above the other objects, since the background image has the text wrapping behind text activated, which automatically makes it a lower level compared to the other objects that are set to in front of text. If this video helped you, then please support this free knowledge by hitting the subscribe and the like button. Thanks a lot, and I see you in the next one.